Hey guys, welcome back to this SQL tutorial series. In this session, we'll be implementing the full join. So the full join basically returns all the records from the left table and also all the records from the right table. So if we take table A and table B, then applying full join on these two tables would give us all the records from table A and also all the records from table B. And wherever the join condition is not met, we'll get null values in that place. So let's have a look at the syntax. Well, start with the select keyword first, and then give in the list of the columns, following which we'll give the from keyword and then give the name of the first table. Then we'll use the keywords full, join, and then give the name of the second table, after which we'll use the keyword on. So this on keyword tells SQL that this full join needs to be done on some condition, and that condition would be values from column X of table 1 should be equal to values of column Y from table 2. So before I go ahead and implement the full join, let me actually have a glance at the employee table and the department table. So I'll start with the employee table first. So select star from, the name of the table is employee. So we have these columns in the employee table: employee ID, employee name, employee salary, employee age, employee gender, and employee department. And we'll be applying the full join on the employee department column. Now let me also have a glance at the department table. Select star from, the name of the table is department. I'll hit execute. So the department table has these three columns: department ID, department name, and department location. And we'll be applying the full join condition on this department name column. So let me start with the syntax for the full join. So I will give in the select keyword first, and then I'll give in the list of all of the columns which I want to select. So I want to select the employee name and the employee department columns from the employee table. So first I'll give in the name of the table, which is employee, and then I'll give in the name of the column, which would be employee name. Similarly, I'd also want the employee department column. So I'll give in the name of the table, employee. I'll put dot over here, and then I'll select the EDEPT column. After that, I'd also want the department name and department location columns from the department table. So I'll give in the name of the table, department. I'll put dot over here, and then I'll select department name. Similarly, I'll also select the department location column. So I will give in the name of the table, I'll put dot, and then I'll select the department location column. After this, I will use the from keyword and then give in the name of the first table, which is employee. Then I will use the keywords full, join, and then give in the name of the second table, which is department. After that, I will give the keyword on, and then specify the condition on the basis of which the full join needs to be done. So the condition is the values of EDEPT column from the employee table should match with the values of the DNAME column from the department table. So that would be employee.EDEPT is equal to department.DNAME. I'll put semicolon over here. Let me hit execute. So this is the result of the full join on the employee table and the department table. So wherever we see null values, that means that the records have not matched over here. So operations is present in the employee table, but it is not present in the department table. So that is why we have null values in the columns extracted from the department table. Similarly, we have content, tech, and finance departments only in the department table. And that is why we have null values in the columns extracted from the employee table. And this is how we can implement the full join. In the next session, we'll learn about self-join. So thanks for attending the session. Let's meet in the next class.